In this video, I want to share the 5 things that I love most about ActiveCampaign. So we're starting with number 5 and then we slowly work our way to number 1, to the thing that I love most. So let's dive right in. So number 5, and it is apps, integrations and webhooks. Because I think it's really important with an email service provider or a tool like ActiveCampaign that you can also connect to other tools so that they can talk to each other, so that you can also automate other things in your business to free up time. So with ActiveCampaign, there's lots of apps. So over here you see a page, and then for example, I don't know, if you're for example using Shopify or maybe WooCommerce, then I can imagine that that's really super duper handy, that whenever a new order comes in, maybe something gets triggered inside ActiveCampaign, and then boom, 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 and this will happen and that will happen. Super cool. But you can also do lots of other things. You can also connect to Facebook, to WordPress, to Zapier, ClickFunnels, Unbounce, lots of other apps and integrations, and I really think this is super duper handy. Now, that's really great, but what you can also do is you can also add webhooks to your automations. And that sounds super techy, but a webhook is basically just a way for a tool to send data over to another tool. So in this case, over here, I have an automation with a free email course. And then at the end of this free email course, I have an authentic deadline that is valid for 3 days. So then I say to people like, hey, this offer you can get for the next 3 days. And then I want to make sure that after those 3 days that people cannot access the deal anymore, right? So to do that, I, for example, use a tool called Deadline Funnel. And then inside my automation, I trigger this webhook that is going to send the context data to Deadline Funnel. And then from Deadline Funnel, I have a little script on my website so that whenever somebody's, for example, visiting the checkout page for that offer after the deadline, that I can automatically redirect them to a different page. Super handy. Or here I have another webhook, and then this webhook is generating the deadline text. So then over here I say, okay, IntegraMod webhook, and then here add 3 days. And then this scenario inside IntegraMod is going to start, and then you can also automate a bunch of things. So I think this is super handy. It's really a must have with an email service provider. So it's really cool that ActiveCampaign is providing all these apps, and that you can also use webhooks for other maybe more custom needs. Number 4, very organized contact profiles. So with ActiveCampaign, obviously you're going to build an email list. And I think it's really great that inside ActiveCampaign, you have such a good overview of your contacts, and that you can also customize that overview a bit. So over here, you see a profile, the profile from John Doe, johndoe@example.com. And then over here, you already see some social media icons. So if ActiveCampaign then finds that person on social media, I'm not sure how they do that, but then those icons will show up, and then you can already go, for example, to their LinkedIn. It's pretty cool. And then over here on the right side, you have a recent activities overview. So then you can, for example, see when somebody entered an automation, completed an automation, when they reached a call inside an automation, or maybe when they opened an email, clicked a link inside an email, visited a page on your website, all that good stuff you can see over there. And then over here at the top, you have the general details of your contact. So over here, you, for example, see that I created 3 custom fields here. So those are not in their standard, I created those myself. But I, for example, wanted to store the contact's birthday, the customer lifetime value, the latest purchase, and then we also have a standard phone field, account field. And then over here, which I think is also really great, is that we also have tags. So with tags, you can add basically like little labels to your contacts that will tell you all kinds of things about them. So for example, I used here to store the things that they're interested in. So if we hear interest, topic, email marketing. So then whenever I send out a newsletter or something, or I add them to an automation that is about email marketing, then I just check, okay, is this person actually interested in this topic? Or what I also do is I use it to track who purchased my online courses. And then, for example, in this case, you see here sales purchased ActiveCampaign workshop. So then when I would promote the ActiveCampaign workshop or something, then I would want to make sure to exclude people that have this tag, right? So all kinds of handy things. And then over here, you also see the lists that they are in, and then also the status. So here you see this green icon over here. And then here you also see the automations that they are in, and then also how far they progressed inside that automation. So over here, you, for example, see evergreen newsletter completion 100%. And then if you want, you can also click here view to see the exact spot inside that automation. So pretty cool. And then the thing that I really love most is that you can create all these custom fields, and then you can organize them into custom field groups. So over here you see that under this icon here, lists, manage fields, you see that I have a whole bunch of custom fields, and then I created groups for those custom fields, because if all of these custom fields would be like in one long list, then I would have really bad overview. But like this, it's really great. So for example, here I created one group that is called segmentation. And then over here, I store, for example, what kind of product type people have. So if they have like digital products, physical products, or maybe offer services. And then I also store the specific product. So then I would ask people if they say like, hey, I sell digital products, and I would ask what kind of digital products. And then if somebody answers online courses, then I would store that into this custom field. So this gives me a good overview of who someone is. Then here a part with engagement. So I would, for example, store when they last visited the website, when they last opened an email, how many emails they opened in total, that kind of stuff. Then I also connected it to my Facebook Messenger bot. And then I, for example, store their ManageChat ID in here, their bot status, if they're subscribed or not, and also the messaging window if it's inside or outside. Then here for webinars, then I would store here dynamically the day, the time, the date, and the link, and all kinds of other handy things. For example, here I also created some custom fields to track where people are coming from. So in this case, I would see, oh, this person is from YouTube. And they clicked on a link inside the video description from this video. So it was really handy stuff. So I really like how organized this is. Number three, conditional content to personalize your emails. And I think this is really truly amazing. When I learned about this, it really blew my mind. I think it's super cool. So let me show you. So what you can do inside an email is you can create different blocks of text, and then you can add a condition to that block of text. And then only when that condition is met, that text will show up. So really simple over here, for example. So here I would say, hey, or I would say, hey, and then the first name personalization tag. So then I would say, hey, John, or hey. But I only show, for example, hey, if, let me go over here, manage conditions, if the first name does not exist, because then I don't want to say, hey, space, explanation mark. But over here, this would show manage condition if the first name exists. Pretty cool, right? But pretty basic. Now then what you could also do is you can also do it based on someone's geolocation. So ActiveCampaign is tracking where people are coming from. And then over here, you can use that to personalize your emails as well. So I could, for example, say, hey, John, how are things in Italy, if I know that they're from Italy? So then over here, you can see the condition geo country equals Italy, and then that text will show up. So then people will already be like, hey, well, okay, hey, this is quite cool and personalized, right? But you can take it even further, and this is actually my favorite use case of it, and it is to just make your emails more relevant based on what you know about that person. So I showed you that over here in these custom fields, I store segmentation. So I would ask questions like, hey, what kind of products are you selling? Oh, okay, cool, digital products, what kind of digital products? And then I can personalize my emails based on these things. So based on what kind of product someone is selling, but also based on maybe their biggest struggle or based on the email service provider you're using. Super, super cool. So then over here, I would say, hey, how are things in Italy? And then, for example, if I know that someone is a marketer, I could say a lot of marketers don't think about how they can keep their list clean of their clients. So then over here, inside this condition, you can see manage condition, specific product. So that's this over here, right? Specific product equals marketing service. So if I know that someone is offering marketing services, then this sentence will show. But if I know that someone is an online course creator, then I would say, hey, how are things? And then this sentence would show up. A lot of online course creators don't think about how they can keep their list clean. So this is just a simple example, right? But you can really go crazy inside your email to really personalize it. So I would recommend to think in your business, okay, like how can you segment your audience in the first place? And how can you use that data to make your emails more relevant? And then, yeah, you can do this conditional content stuff, which I think is really amazing. Number two, it's very scalable and future-proof. So I really, really, really like that. I've been using ActiveCampaign, I think, for the last 4 or 5 years when I started my online business. And then it was like a teeny, teeny, tiny business with just like maybe, I don't know, 50 people on the list. And then it was already great because I could just make like a simple setup. And as my business started growing, I could also expand everything inside ActiveCampaign to make it fit my needs. And I think that's really great because the switching costs of having to switch to another platform when you're maybe outgrowing it can be quite high. Because imagine that you create, I don't know, 10, 20, 30 automations, and then you realize like, actually I need a bit more, I don't know, advanced tool. And then you would have to switch, and then, I don't know, you maybe have to take days or weeks to like set that over. So I really love that ActiveCampaign is very scalable, it's very future-proof, and it doesn't matter if you have 50 people on your email list or if you have 50,000 people on your email list. And then number one, automations, because I absolutely love the visual automation builder inside ActiveCampaign that you see over here that you can then use to build all kinds of automations to really automate everything from the moment that they opt in till the moment that they become a customer. So usually what I, for example, do is that I have an automation with the download delivery. So somebody is requesting some kind of maybe checklist or cheat sheet from their website, then this automation would deliver that download. Then after that, I would have the onboarding automation. So this is that onboarding automation. So I would have a couple of emails, and then inside those emails, I would invite people for example, a free email course or a free webinar. And then after the webinar or the email course, I would pitch one of my products with a limited time offer that is valid for 3 days. And then after that, doesn't matter if they purchase or not, they would go into the Evergreen newsletter. And the Evergreen newsletter is basically like a regular newsletter, but then all the emails are already pre-written and will be automatically sent out once a week. And then every 2 or 3 months, we go back into the pitch automation, and then either a different product will be pitched or the same product with maybe a different offer to try to sell them again. And then afterwards they go into the Evergreen newsletter again, and so on and so on and so on. So I think these automations inside ActiveCampaign, truly incredible, super cool that you can make all this and that you can automate all these steps, automate all these emails, throw people inside other automations, take them outside an automation, super, super duper cool. So these are the things that I love most about ActiveCampaign, but it's not all sunshine. So in general, I really love ActiveCampaign, but there's also some things that I really hate about ActiveCampaign. So if you're curious about that, then be sure to check out this video over here. And if you have any questions about any of the things that I've just shared, then just let me know in the comments below.